William Vito, Black Bill Taco, born Guglielmo Vito Taco, Italian, Latin small letter script G U, Latin small letter turned Y, modifier letter vertical line, Latin small letter turned Y, Latin small letter open A Lmo Vi, modifier letter triangular colon to Tolco, February 12, 1897, May 28, 1972 was an Italian-American mobster from Grosse Pointe Park, Michigan and a founding member of the Detroit Partnership of La Cosa Nostra. Early life. Taco was born Guglielmo Vito Taco in Terrazzini, Sicily on February 12, 1897. He was one of seven children born to Giacomo Taco and Nicolina Moseri. In 1912, the Taco family immigrated to Detroit, Michigan. Taco became a naturalized citizen after serving in the United States Army during World War I. The company continued producing malt products and did well for around 5 years. Then it was changed to the Pfeiffer Products Company. On February 5, 1932, Taco was arrested for conspiracy to violate the National Prohibition Act. 8 days after the raid, a federal injunction closed Pfeiffer Products and Meyer Products for alleged war production. Not long after this, Zerilli and Taco were barred from participating in the legal beer business by the Michigan Liquor Control Commission and ordered to sell their interest in the Pfeiffer Brewing. Criminal career. After returning to Detroit, Taco joined his cousin Giuseppe Zerilli and Angelo Melli in backing the Ginola Brothers bootlegging operations. On August 11, 1920, he was arrested for the murder of Antonio Badalamenti, a Vitali gang leader killed in retaliation for an attack on Giuseppe Manzello and Angelo Palizzi. The charges were dropped 2 days later. With Manzello dead, Melli took over the Ginola gang, renaming it the East Side Mob, and appointing Taco and Zerilli as his top aides. After Giovanni Vitali's death on October 2, 1920, Salvatore Catalano dominated the Sicilian crime syndicate and organized the Pascuzzi Combine, a liquor syndicate consisting of the remaining gangs. With profits made by Taco and Zerilli's in the Pascuzzi Combine, they purchased the Pfeiffer Brewing Company. Pfeiffer's assets were then taken over by States Products Company. Personal life. In 1928, Taco married Rosalia Zerilli and purchased land in Grosse Pointe Park where they raised their seven children, including Jack Taco. Taco's success earned him respect from mafia families nationwide. He was a major factor in aligning the partnership with several crime families, including the Profaci crime family in New York. In 1952, his son Anthony Taco married Carmela Profaci, daughter of Joe Profaci. In 1953, Taco's daughter, Grace, married Carlo Licata, the son of Nick Licata, a former mobster who was ousted by the Detroit family and was adopted by the Los Angeles crime family headed by Jack Dragna. Nick Licata attended the wedding in Detroit and was back in good standing with the partnership. The Hazel Park Racetrack. The outfit's involvement with Hazel Park began in 1948 following the visit of a local auto dealer, Waldo Andrews, to the law office of James Belanca. Andrews had secured a 30-day option letter to purchase the Hazel Park Stadium Company, HPSC. Andrews then went on to fill Belanca in with the details of the company plans, which centered around the proposed construction of an automobile or harness racing track in Hazel Park, Michigan. Belanca started soliciting for investors, who happened to be Taco and Joe Zerilli. Through this they formed a second corporation, named Hazel Park Racing Association. The track was finished after Belanca obtained money from the syndicate leaders. Hazel Park's success led to a dispute between HPSC's original incorporators and Belanca's Hazel Park Racing Association. Taco, Zerilli and Belanca expanded their interest in horse racing on June 27, 1957, by purchasing the Wheeling Downs Racetrack in Wheeling, West Virginia. Last years and death. Taco spent most of the last 9 years of his life in Miami, Florida. On May 28, 1972, he died in Bonseekers Hospital, now Beaumont Hospital, in Grosse Pointe City, Michigan. He was 75 years old and he left behind his wife Rosalia, his children, and 28 grandchildren. The funeral was held in the Church of the Holy Family in Detroit. He is buried in Holy Sepulchre Cemetery. Notes: External links. William Taco at Find a Grave.